फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड? व्हाट इज द बैकग्राउंड व्हाई दिस म्यूचुअल फंड केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस? सो बेसिकली वी हैव डिफरेंट सोर्स ऑफ लाइक डिफरेंट प्लेसेस वेयर वी कैन इन्वेस्ट. वी हैव शेयर मार्केट, वी हैव बॉन्ड मार्केट, वी हैव गोल्ड, वी हैव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ इंडेक्स एटसेट्रा, है ना. तो वी कैन इन्वेस्ट हियर, बट इन्वेस्टमेंट हियर दैट रिक्वायर्स सम काइंड ऑफ प्रोफेशनल एक्सपर्टीज, है ना. इफ यू आर नॉट प्रोफेशनल एक्सपर्ट, यू कैन लूज योर मनी, यू कैन लूज योर मनी. सो सपोज वी टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ए सैलरीड पर्सन. सैलरीड पर्सन जॉइंस हिज ऑफिस एट 10 AM इन द मॉर्निंग एंड लीव्स हिज ऑफिस एट 6 PM इन द इवनिंग. इन बिटवीन द टाइम ही इज बिजी इन हिज वर्क, ऑफिस वर्क, एंड द दिस स्टॉक मार्केट, बॉन्ड मार्केट इज वर्किंग ओनली इन दिस टाइम. सो द पर्सन इज नॉट अवेयर अबाउट वॉट इज हैपनिंग इन द स्टॉक मार्केट बिकॉज द पर्सन इज बिजी इन द ऑफिस वर्क. And there are chances that the prices of his investment, they can fluctuate very, very, in a very big way. So something happened in Syria, global oil market fluctuated and Indian stock market also fluctuated, and in minutes, lakhs of investment of Mr. the salaried person washed away. So there is a lot of risk. Mr. The salaried person does not have any professional expertise. He don't have the time. Right? So to take care of such issues, these mutual funds were introduced. So how do mutual fund work? A small, small investor, they invest into a mutual fund. They invest into a mutual fund, and this mutual fund, it hires the professionals. It has the professional fund managers who have expertise in the share market, who have time, who are paid, right? And it invests into different areas like equity, bond, index, gold, real estate. So different investment avenues are used and the investment is made in such avenues, right? And based upon such investment, whatever return they earn, out of that return, they reduce the administrative expenses, and rest of the money they give back to the investors, right? So these are the salaried person, they are the those people who don't have the time, those people who have the money but don't know much about the market, right? So these small investors, they get an opportunity to participate into the different investment avenues with the professional expertise. So these are the mutual fund, right? These are the mutual fund. Now these mutual fund, they can invest into two primary instruments. One is the equity and another is the debt. So equity, that means they are buying the equity shares, and debt means they are buying the bonds or they are buying the debentures, right? And both of them have their own advantages and disadvantages. For example, the investment into the equity shares, it is risky in nature, but it can provide huge returns. The investment into the debt, it is less risky, but returns are also limited, right? So both have their own set of benefit and disadvantages. So primarily, we can have two categories, and inside this category, they can be many other subcategories of the mutual fund. there can be many other subcategories of the mutual fund, right? So this is about the mutual fund, and there is one more term in the mutual fund, that is NAV or net asset value, right? So what is net asset value and what is the use of net asset value? So basically, if Mr. A is one of the investor in the mutual fund, he invested ₹100 in the mutual fund, right? He invested ₹100 in the mutual fund. Now mutual fund received this money, and mutual fund further invested, and today the value of this ₹100 investment is ₹110. The value of this investment is ₹110. So ₹110 out of this mutual fund reduce its own expenses, suppose ₹2, and ₹108 is the net asset value of this investment amount, right? So basically this net asset value is basically the kind of market price. It is a kind of market price of the mutual fund unit, hai na? So if you buy the mutual fund at any point of time in your life, in your account the company will reflect net asset value. So net asset value is basically, if you want to sell it right now, then this will be the value you can realize immediately, right? So this is the value you can realize immediately. And there are some formula to calculate this net asset value, that is not important for us. Now there is a concept of exchange traded fund, which is related to this mutual fund only, right? So we will discuss about each one of them in the study material also, but let us see here about the exchange traded fund. So exchange traded fund is basically one of the mutual fund only, but they are traded on the stock exchange. They are traded on the stock exchange. That means if the trading is happening on the stock exchange, that means their price can fluctuate multiple times in a single day, unlike the normal mutual fund. In case of normal mutual fund, we calculate the NAV only once in a day, right? So the primary difference between the normal mutual fund and the exchange traded fund is that they are traded on the exchange and their price can fluctuate multiple times in a single day, right? So this is the exchange traded fund. This is the exchange traded fund. Now there is a term CPSE ETF. CPSE ETF, CPSE means Central Public Sector Enterprise, means those enterprises which are owned majorly by the central government. For example, we have NTPC, we have Indian Oil Corporation, we have ONGC, etc. Right? So this CPSE ETF, suppose this is a CPSE ETF, this is a fund, mutual fund. The retail investors, they are investing into this fund. This fund will invest further only in the shares of selected CPSEs, right? So it will invest only and only in the shares of selected central public sector enterprises, right? So who are the selected CPSE? They can change from time to time. They can change from time to time. And One of the major advantage of this CPSC ETF is that they also provide one of the source of disinvestment, right? So basically, the government of India is selling its shares to the CPSE fund, and CPSE fund is basically buying the government of India shares in different CPSEs, right? So government of India selling its shares means disinvestment. So government of India ka jo disinvestment hai, the CPSE fund are basically investing there. So they are providing the opportunity for the small investors to invest into the central PSUs, and the government can sell its shares to this central public sector undertaking ETF. Thereby, it can raise the disinvestment proceed from this issue, right? This is about the CPSE ETF. One another term is Bharat 22. So Bharat 22 is basically set of 22 blue chip stocks. It means that the investors will invest into this Bharat 22, and this Bharat 22 will invest into the 22 blue chip stocks. What is the meaning of blue chip? Blue chip means who have been Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, blue chip stocks means those stocks which are, very sound financially sound and very strong. So, those companies who have been there for a long period of time, who have very good performance, for example, Tata's. So, they are classified as the blue chip stocks, right? So they are basically investing into the blue chip stock. These blue chip stock can be both from the PSU or they can be from the private sector also, right? They can be both from the PSU as well as the private sector, but primarily from the PSUs, from the private sector very, very less. This is about the Bharat 22. There is one more fund which has been introduced very recently. That is Bharat Bond ETF. So in this case, basically the fund will invest into the bonds of corporates, right? Bonds of corporate. So basically, the Bharat 22, it invests into the equity stocks, and this Bharat bond, it will invest into the debt funds, right? So Bharat bond ETF is basically the counterpart of Bharat 22, and the only difference is that it is dealing in the equity and it is investing into the debt. So it is a equity ETF and this is a debt ETF, right? So these are the basic terms. Now we will see in detail on the study material and you will get more clarity about these terms from this material. And then after that, if you have any doubt, you can ask me. So just read this mutual fund. So mutual fund is an investment vehicle that is made up of a pool of funds that collects money from many investors to invest in securities such as stock, bond, short-term debt to maximize investors' profit. Say they do not eliminate the profit, they do not eliminate the risk. Wo risk eliminate nahi kar sakte. है ना, क्योंकि जो रिस्क इन्वेस्टमेंट जहाँ पे भी उन्होंने इन्वेस्टमेंट किया है उसका तो रिस्क रहना ही रहना है, वो तो रिस्क रहेगा ही रहेगा. ओनली थिंग दे कैन डू इज बेसिकली, ओनली थिंग दे कैन डू इज बेसिकली दैट दे कैन मिनिमाइज द रिस्क बाय इन्वेस्टिंग प्रोफेशनली इन टू द डिफरेंट सिक्योरिटीज. दे कैन जस्ट मिनिमाइज द रिस्क एंड दे चार्ज द मिनिमम फीस. एंड म्यूचुअल फंड्स आर एन आइडियल इन्वेस्टमेंट व्हीकल फॉर द रेगुलर इन्वेस्टर हु डू नॉट नो मच अबाउट द इन्वेस्टिंग. जिसको ज़्यादा इन्वेस्टमेंट के बारे में जानकारी नहीं है, इट इज गुड फॉर दैम. सॉरी, इन्वेस्टर्स कैन चूज अ म्यूचुअल फंड स्कीम बेस्ड ऑन देयर फाइनेंशियल गोल एंड दे आर अंडर सेबी रेगुलेशंस. देन देयर इज अ टर्म नेट एसेट वैल्यू, सो इट वेरीज ऑन अ डेली बेसिस एंड इट इज अ क्यूमुलेटिव मार्केट वैल्यू. सो बेसिकली दिस इज द मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट्स ऑफ द फंड एंड देन देयर इज अ फॉर्मूला. देयर कैन बी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड. फर्स्ट इक्विटी म्यूचुअल फंड हु आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन टू द स्टॉक्स दैट इज इन द शेयर्स and debt funds who are investing into the bonds and the government securities. Then we have debt schemes. So these are different schemes. If you have time, you can go through. Otherwise, not important, right? Not important for the examination unless and until something is in news. So these are self-explanatory. You can go through them. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Total expense ratio is basically simply the total fund cost divided by total fund asset, right? तो टोटल को फंड जो होता है, म्यूचुअल फंड जो होता है, उसको मैनेज करने में जितनी कॉस्ट आती है वो आपकी स्टाफ कॉस्ट है, आपकी बाकी बहुत सारे एक्सपेंसेस होते हैं, डिवाइडेड बाय द टोटल फंड वैल्यू. जो आपका अमाउंट टोटल उन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया है उसकी वैल्यू कितनी है, तो दैट इज टोटल एक्सपेंस रेशियो. एंड दिस विल एक्चुअली हेल्प इन व्हाई डू वी कैलकुलेट टोटल एक्सपेंस रेशियो, सो दैट वी कैन नो वेदर द एक्सपेंसिस विच आर देयर आर रीजनेबल और नॉट. तो जो खर्चे हो रहे हैं वो रीजनेबल हैं या नहीं है, सिर्फ उसके लिए हम लोग इसको कैलकुलेट करते हैं, ठीक है. नॉट दैट मच इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन. या दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट, एक्सचेंज ट्रेडिड फंड. सो टेक 2 मिनट एंड रीड दिस स्लाइड योर सेल्फ. Okay, so in this slide, one or two important aspects I would like to tell. They are listed. Listed means they are registered in the stock exchange and they can be traded. So they can be traded in the secondary market, है ना? तो कोई भी इसको buy कर सकता है, कोई भी sell कर सकता है इसको. ये passive fund है. Passive means the fund manager will not be selecting कि आपको कहाँ पे invest करना है. मतलब already the shares have been identified. For example, we take the case of CPSE ETF. In case of CPSE ETF, the selected companies have already been identified by the fund initially. Starting mein hi wo identify ho gayi thi. Now, the fund manager will just
put the money in that stock. So they are not actively managing the stock. They are just putting the money into that stock as per the predefined formula. So they are copying an index. Index matlab, suppose there are 10 stocks. So they will decide that how much money will go in each one of the stock. So some stock will get 7% value, some stock will get 10% fund, some stock will get 20% fund. So different stock or different shares will be given different percentage of the investment from the fund. Again, there is a net asset value, which I already told, just like in the mutual fund, they also have the net asset value. Now, there are two types of ETF, gold ETF, where the participant will deposit the gold, hai na? So, wo gold deposit karenge, hai na? Another is index ETF created by institutional investors who swap shares in the index basket for you. So, basically, yahan par investment in the shares hota hai. Swapping shares matlab, they will buy the shares exactly in the same proportion in which a particular index has invested. For example, there is a index of Bombay Stock Exchange, that is BSE index, hai na? So in that BSE index, there are top 30 shares, right? So this index ETF will be investing in those top 30 shares, right? Then we have CPSE ETF. So it was launched in 2014 and it is managed by Reliance Nippon Asset Management Fund. So the fund manager is this, hai na? So fund manager jo hai, wo kon hai? Reliance Nippon Asset Management, jiska kaam hai professional support provide karna, hai na? The first CPSE ETF was, it consisted of 10 PSUs. You do not need to remember the name of these 10 PSUs. And later on, the government replaced three existing companies with the new three companies. Again, you do not need to remember the name of which company go on, which company come in, hai na? So now there are total 11 companies in the CPSE ETF. The government gave 5% discount at the launch of CPSE ETF to retail investor. So basically, jab CPSE ETF mein, like when CPSE ETF invested the money in the government shares, the government shares were sold to the CPSE ETF at the 5% discount, hai na? So the government wanted that more and more retail investors should invest into the government securities, into the government shares, hai na? So the amount which is being disinvested by the government from the PSEs, more and more retail investors should come and invest into that to attract them, to encourage their participation. The government gave 5% discount for the retail investors, hai na? Then we have Bharat 22, hai na? So it consists of 22 stocks of CPSEs, public sector banks, and strategic holding of SUTI. What is SUTI? Specific undertaking of the UTI, hai na? So this unit trust of India, this was one of the first company which initiated the idea of mutual fund in the country, right? But this company went into crisis, and now this special undertaking of unit trust of India is representing this UTI. And this UTI has invested their money into some good companies, private companies basically, hai na? So private company mein jaise ITC ho gaya through SUTI and Axis Bank through SUTI. So you will find only two private companies in the Bharat 22, and those also through the UTI, which is a government enterprise. So practically dekha jaye to all of these stock are the government stock only, public sector stock only, hai na? But one SUTI is also having share in the two private companies, ITC and the Axis Bank. That is why the two private companies are also receiving the investment from Bharat 22. So in the examination, if they ask that Bharat 22 invests into the only into the public sector companies, so your answer will be yes, because you can see it consists of CPSE, that is a central public sector enterprises, PSBs, public sector banks, and strategic holding of the SOTI, which is a government company again, hai na? So in this case, discount of 3% was offered, hai na? So in case of CPSE ETF, 5% discount. In case of Bharat 22, 3% discount, hai na? So this is a mechanism where the government can divest a small portion of its stake in the big basket, hai na? So for example, many a time the central government has been selling the shares in these companies, in the NTPC. So I have actually already worked for more than 5 years in this company, NTPC. So I know about this, and other companies also. In all these companies, the government has been selling its shares, maybe 2%, 5%, 10%. So a small portion of its shares is being sold. So it will keep both investors and employees happy, hai na? Also by mixing the matching the wealth. So now ICICI Prudential will be the fund manager, and Asia Index Private Limited will be the index provider. Index provider means it will decide that which index should be followed, in what proportion should we invest in all these companies, hai na? And ICICI Prudential AMC is the asset management company, which is basically doing the execution work. Then we have Bharat Bond ETF, which was launched in the end of 2019. So this is a debt ETF, and it will hold the bonds issued by PSEs owned by the government of India, hai na? The bond which have been issued by the government of India, PSEs, hai na? So only and only corporate which are owned by the government of India. So this is the first corporate bond ETF, and is the first fixed income ETF. Fixed income, why? Because it is investing into the debt fund, and debt fund are the fixed income provider. It is a pure debt fund. Its equity counterpart is Bharat 22 fund. And where does it invest? It invests into the AAA rated bond. So this is the credit rating of the bond. That means this establishes the credibility of the bond. So AAA means they are highly credible. The companies like REC, PFC, NHAI, they have a good history of repayment to their investors. So they are much more safe. What is the minimum and maximum amount of investment? The minimum amount of investment is 1000 rupees bond, and there is no maximum limit. But for the retail investor, there is an upper limit of 2 lakh rupees. And why 2 lakh rupees limit? Because for the retail investors, some kind of discount is given. So we will count retail investor only and only when there is an upper limit of 2 lakh rupees. In this case, the index will be constructed by the NSE. And what is the advantage? So advantage is there is an assured return. So there will be some promised return. There will be some beneficial tax treatment. So if the fund is held for more than 3 years, the tax on the interest will be exempt. It will be tax free. And there is liquidity, because they can be sold anytime, because they are listed in the stock market, right? So assured return, beneficial tax treatment, and liquidity, all of them are the advantages. Now what are the objectives, why they have been introduced? Because the government want to deepen the Indian debt market. I already told you yesterday that we want to raise more and more fund for the long term, but our source of fund, which include the bank, which include other sources of fund, those sources of fund are basically not providing fund for the long time. So the government want to improve the bond market. So this Bharat Bond ETF will go a long way in improving the situation of the India's debt market, as well as it will help PSU companies to raise the funding for their operations.